Hello all, this is Jaames Johnson, aka Sulfurblade, and I am back here with Stormworks. Yes, I've been on a foundation kick the last few days, and indeed I've also been doing some hunting with my buddy Durant. But Stormworks needs some attention too, so with that being said, I'm back in Stormworks. I'm gonna run up and grab the next mission. See what that mission has for me. Wait, store nuclear waste. Evidently, I need to go to the nuclear place and do this, so I didn't need to run up here after all. Yes. That's what I'm looking for. Very fine-tuned. Quite happy with that ship at this point. Though, there's one problem. I still feel like, well, I want to be pushed to upgrade. So, the game needs to start throwing some stuff at me that's gonna put me out of the comfort of what this little ship can do. You know what I mean? Maybe I should consider trying to redesign this for two engines. I'd also love to know how fast I'm going, so maybe I should figure out how to put a speedometer on the boat. There we have a planetary body setting as this planetary body is rising. Okay, three containers of Inferno Waste require storage in the Inferno Storage Tank in the sky. Specialist engineers required are not... Specialist engineers required are not available, but the waste has been removed from the reactor. Is that the station where they dispose of the use support room? Move the waste from the upper level to the underground structure. I don't know if doing 1 in 10 is a good idea or a bad idea. I don't know what I'm going to find down here. I'm going to need the forklift to switch traveling or what, but I figure I have enough time to... I have a hunch that I'm going to need to do it all the time. Or that 1 in 10 won't really matter so much. think that's what I need to do. Yeah, 1 of 3. Okay. I'd say this forklift is pretty cool. You know, the lightning does, at least the first couple of times you ever hear it, scare the crap out of you. But at this point, the weather starts to become annoying. I suppose bad weather is kind of part of the game based around the Coast Guard, I suppose. thinking about how I might put another engine in here. Yeah, I could just stick it in the back there, but that's also the cargo room. I don't want to put it off the front somehow. I need to get the stuff down here and then go there. Yeah. There was a way I could just kind of like cut bow off the front and add some area in the middle without having to like completely delete everything. components to change the properties of the components while I let it flip. Select parts of your vehicle to cut, copy, and paste to rotate and flip them around. Export a selection as a new vehicle. This might be what I'm looking for. What did I do? It's all the red. Sometimes I really hate the controls for moving around in this mode. think all the logic is fine. I think we should be pretty much set to go. This is a cargo mission, so I'm gonna need to make room for cargo. Alright, we should be ready. Whoa, what happened here? Must be merged, huh? What's the colors about? Merge two vehicle bodies. Different bodies are denoted by different colors. Click on a body to select it, and then click on an adjacent one to merge them. Looks like it's holding together. Thank you. feel that much faster. Maybe that's because we added weight. But she could be going faster. How would I know? I don't have a speedometer. As we pick up a little more, I'd like to see how stable this boat is. Now that I've made these tweaks, I think she might be more stable than she was before. If it wasn't for the prow, I could possibly make a... Well, maybe I could even put the prow. I kinda wanna make a duck. An amphibious vehicle that I can drive on the land. Change that front chair to the pilot chair, and how it would look from a first person perspective. Because obviously this perspective isn't as good as that of that chair would be. sure get a lot of altimeter improvements. Alright, so we delivered the stuff and nothing really happened. I guess it'll probably trigger when we get back. I wonder if I changed to 4 propellers if that would make things faster. But then again, I have no idea how fast I'm going, because I still have put a speedometer on the map. should be able to dock large rotor, fluid flow valve, fluid meter. No, I don't think that does that. I don't think it does. Maybe it just works automatically. Maybe I gotta connect it to a display. That might be the ticket. It's a sensor, right? So it should be sensing stuff. Digital display. The sensor output, is it current linear? works. So get between 10 and 12. At least two faster. Whatever the unit of measurement that is, if that's a knot, a pound per hour. Alright, so I think we've learned some stuff, and this seems like a good point to probably end this episode. So we did a couple more missions. We have positively increased the speed of the boat by 2 by adding 2 more propellers onto it. Turning is a little bit problematic with the extra propellers, a little more problematic than it used to be, I think, because of having the power out to the sides of the ship. So there's that. But all in all, as long as you slow down into the turns, it's not that big of a deal. It still is very stable, and so anyway, this has been another look at Stormworks Build and Rescue. We did a couple missions, and until next time, all, peace.